One of the things that we in society often fail to do is to put a value around all of the benefits that forests provide. Forests are part of society's infrastructure. They filter water just like a treatment plant would. They draw down carbon from the atmosphere. They control floods like a dam or a dike. They protect seashores, mangrove forests, just like a seawall. We sometimes can put too much hope into data and technology, but I do believe it is a game changer in providing us the real-time data to make smart decisions. Can we prove that a standing forest is more valuable than one on the ground? I started my career in traditional corporate finance. On the weekends, while I was out hiking in the forest, I found myself trying to understand, was there a pathway where I could connect my personal passions with a professional trajectory? And now, having spent almost 15 years with the World Resources Institute, really bringing together all of those past experiences to think about how we drive different sources of funding and financing to really address the challenges that are impacting society. A balanced forest ecosystem is one that is resilient, one that has its ups and downs, but in the end can continue to thrive and function and provide the services for people living in and around those forests. Unfortunately, for many, many years, we have seen an increase in deforestation. Just last year, in tropical forests alone, we lost nearly 10 football fields of primary tropical forests a minute. When we cut more than regrowth can occur in a short term, that is when you lost that sustainable idea and when you need to rethink your approach to forestry. One of the most challenging elements in the forestry and environmental sector is measuring success. The World Resources Institute has come up with approaches to bridge technology, satellite imagery, AI, with on-the-ground community verification to track the health of our forests. We now have the ability with tools like Global Forest Watch, anywhere in the world, down to a few meters of resolution, be able to see what is happening in our forest. Was that a legal harvest, or was it happening in a protected area? And we now have the ability to, in almost immediate terms, provide that information to local forest officials to help them with enforcement and tracking. It is a game changer that will really help local communities sift through to take the most important information and use it to drive their decision making. Our ability to track progress with satellites is likely to expedite market development. We need to be thinking about how to set science-based targets for corporations, financial institutions, and governments to do more and to do it faster for forests and nature. Forests truly are a form of infrastructure and need to be thought about and invested in like we do our brick and mortar infrastructure. And if we are able to do that and think about the green forest alongside the gray, the brick and mortar, we are much more likely to unlock large-scale capital to ensure forest conservation and restoration. You are increasingly seeing many different companies step up to enhance the health of forests and natural systems. And they're not simply doing it for the green PR. They have done the analysis and they understand that they benefit from healthy forests. Think about a major beverage company in the US. Most of the water, especially in the Western United States, comes from forested systems. If you don't have healthy forests, you cannot have your soda or your beer. They very much understand that their bottom line is dependent upon forests. And more you're seeing companies make investments to ensure that the water they need as their primary ingredient is protected. They need to restore forests so that they can spend less money on chemicals and treatment downstream. Many people may not know that traditional commercial and investment banks have large sustainability programs that are quite hungry for investable deals in the forest sector. And traditionally, that has been forestry for lumber. But increasingly, deals are focused on forests for carbon, even forests for habitat and biodiversity. At the World Resources Institute, we do the economic analysis that shows what that return on investment looks like by protecting and restoring priority forest areas, taking an approach that puts a monetary value on services like water, energy security, human health, can lead to large-scale investment, which means healthy communities and healthy forests. We really need to be taking what we call an adaptive management approach, using the best science, robust engagement with communities, government, corporations. I am hopeful that in a bizarre way, as we see more fires, more floods, more impacts from the loss of nature, you'll see more politicians getting on board and start to think beyond just the next election cycle. Managing forests is a endeavor for perpetuity. We will have to go back into that same forest area and continue to manage our forests over time in a changing climate, in a changing reality of what communities and society really need.